Hi everyone, I'm Tom, and this is my review of the Replicape. And I know some of you are getting tired of control board reviews, but with the Replicape, I think I've covered all the main ones. When you're sorting them by processing grunt, there's all the 8-bit megabase boards at rock bottom. They're just barely fast enough to run a basic print and often struggle with delta configurations. Typical examples of those are the RAMs, the RAM Bo, the Sangunulununuino, and everything that sits on top of a physical Arduino Mega. Then there's the Smoothie class of boards that use a faster 32-bit Cortex M3 or M4 microcontroller with, of course, the Smoothie board itself, but also boards like the Aztec X5 Mini that uses the same architecture and software. And those boards are fast enough to run basically any printer at basically any speed. Sure, they're not like overkill fast, but they're more than fast enough for basically any printer. And then there is the all-in more is better class that builds on something like the BeagleBone Black, which is much closer to the amount of processing power your phone or tablet has than to something like an Arduino. The BeagleBone Black runs Linux on a 1 GHz A8 core, so instead of having to use a separate Raspberry Pi to get something like Octoprint running, that entire functionality plus the controller itself is now integrated into the BeagleBone with the Replicape. And the question that usually comes up at this point is going to be, why can't you just use a Raspberry Pi instead? And I'll be covering that later in the video when I talk about the soft side of things. But for now, I want to start it with the Replicape hardware. And as some of you might know, when I'm not doing 3D printing things, I work as a hardware engineer for a large automotive supplier. And I have to admit, the Replicape is actually really, really nicely built and engineered. And it's pretty obvious that cost wasn't much of a concern when this was designed. This is some industrial level stuff right here. So, as a board that plugs into a BeagleBone Black, it doesn't have any kind of processing power itself and only provides the high power part of the entire controller concept. And that includes 5 beefy Texas Instruments DRV8825 drivers that provide enough current for even for light duty CNC mills, and the output current can be precisely adjusted in software so that you don't accidentally melt your motor mounts, which is totally possible with these drivers if you aren't careful. It also carries 3 high-power MOSFETs and proper drivers with a freewheeling diode for each of them. Both of these extra features mean that the MOSFET will run more efficiently and reliably than when you're just leaving them out. And they're typically not things that other boards use, mostly because, well, you can do without them if you really have to. The Replicape has 2 of the outputs labeled for hot ends and the center one for a heated bed, which all run off the same input voltage, which, by the way, can be anywhere between 12 and 24 volt. Each of these outputs can easily provide 15 amps of current or more, limited by the rating of the connector, while the heated bed output should even keep up with something around 30 amps, so these power outputs should be more than enough for anything that you might want to use them with. Most other boards already have trouble running the heated bed outputs at slightly over 10 amps, often because the connectors are going to melt down or because the MOSFET is not properly controlled. There are also 3 smaller MOSFETs on the Replicape intended for running smaller stuff like hot end fans or LEDs, and they are run off of a buck mode switching power supply that efficiently converts whatever input voltage you supply the board with into a perfect 12 volt rail, as long as you're providing it with more than 12 volts. So, even if you want to drive your heated bed and stepper drivers from 24 volt, because that's just more efficient overall, you don't have to worry about getting 24 volt LEDs and fans as well. You can just use regular cheap 12 volt ones. As far as inputs go, it's pretty much the standard fare. 1 thermistor input for each heater output, 6 sensitive inputs, and 1 for a digital Dallas temperature sensor, which isn't really something that's commonly used, but yeah, it's there. 2 more things about the Replicape hardware. 1, it uses a mini automotive fuse for protecting everything, which is awesome. And 2, additionally to the 1 buck converter that makes 12 volt from the input voltage, it has another one that's supplying the BeagleBone Black, which means that you won't have to worry about adding yet another 5 volt power supply like you have to with a lot of the Arduino based platforms, even when you're running off of 24 volt. So that was the hardware side of things, and to sum everything up, Again, while it isn't packed with 24 motor channels and a bazillion unnecessary features, it is an extremely well-made dual extruder board or triple extruder if you leave out the heated bit. Now, let's move on to the softer-ish side of things, and I'll start out with that Raspberry Pi question I mentioned earlier to get it out of the way. And to understand that entire topic, you'll have to know a bit about how processors work. Simply speaking, there are two ways you could use a processor. One is by simply running the code on the processor core with just one single task, a single thread, and without any operating system to manage the resources it has. So, kind of like a Chinese factory worker that only does a single task or a very fixed sequence of tasks all day long, over and over again. Nothing else, nothing out of the ordinary. This is the typical domain of real-time microcontrollers like the Atmega or the Cortex on the smoothie board. They don't run an operating system and only do that one specific task of controlling and monitoring your 3D printer. The other class is something like the ARM cores on your phone, the BeagleBone or the Raspberry Pi, or even the x86 CPU in your full-size computer or laptop. They all run some sort of operating system to dynamically manage a bunch of tasks that are supposed to run at the same time instead of in a recurring fixed sequence. So, more like a secretary who might stop working through emails once the boss, the operating system, comes in and gives a new high priority task. So the problem here is that unless you use a very specialized real-time operating system, there's absolutely no guarantee that the set of tasks, for example moving the stepper motors one increment at a time, are done regularly. So when the network task comes along and wants the processor to send out the octoprint interface right now over Wi-Fi, the task that's in charge of creating physical pulses for the stepper drivers might end up not getting enough processing power to do that regularly and at the exact times it needs to. And that would lead to pretty choppy movement. So while these processors are overall fast enough to directly run a printer, you can't automatically assume that they'll be as reliable as a dedicated microcontroller. So the BeagleBone Black does run a full-blown Linux operating system, and it's not of the real-time variety. So how does it manage to keep the printer's axes moving smoothly? Well, unlike the Raspberry Pi, the BeagleBone includes a pair of PRUs, which are essentially two extra real-time microcontrollers. It's pretty much the same thing as having two of the processors from the smoothie board integrated onto the BeagleBone Black, and those two cores are what make sure that the entire Replicape keeps working in a synchronous fashion. So obviously the borders between the printer firmware and the operating system or printer host are pretty blurred. And to make things even less similar to what you'd expect with a Raspberry Pi, the BeagleBone Black doesn't run from the microSD card that you can plug into the bottom, but instead has additional flash memory on board and only uses the microSD card if you want to change whatever is installed on the BeagleBone's flash or if you want some extra storage. By default, the BeagleBone comes with Debian Linux installed. Again, the same basic operating system you'd use on a Raspberry Pi with Raspbian, hence the name Raspbian. And there are instructions available that guide you through each step of setting up Redeem, which is what used to be the printer's firmware and generally the software that interfaces with the Replicape. Then it tells you how to set up a host like Octoprint, maybe adding a slicer, and theoretically you'd be good to go. So I grabbed a micro HDMI to HDMI cable and a USB keyboard and mouse, connected the BeagleBone to my monitor, and started hacking away. But this turned out to be a ridiculously complex and convoluted process that had me digging around in a terminal window more than I usually like to, and in the end, things started falling apart and were just generally not working. I don't know about you, but not only does it feel like the entire setup could be easily automated with a script, but it's just overall not something I really want to deal with when trying to get a new printer running, especially since not only are there already enough things you need to worry about, but there's also no way of just testing the printer unless the entire software chain is properly set up on the BeagleBone. So even though building on top of the pre-installed Debian distribution seemed like a good idea at first, it clearly wasn't the best practice option. The alternative being a pre-built thing image, which is based on Angstrom, an embedded Linux distribution that is still somewhat similar to Debian, but this image comes with everything ready to rock. Flashing a new image to the BeagleBone Black is again quite similar to flashing a custom ROM to your phone. You basically download an image file, burn that to an SD card, which then boots up and flashes the internal flash memory of the BeagleBone with the new image. And lo and behold, everything was there. Well, almost. The BeagleBone now offers a web-based interface that gives you options to configure the firmware settings and adapt it to your needs. However, there really isn't all that much that you can configure feature-wise. Of course, it supports both Cartesian, so the typical box type printers, as well as Delta machines, and it does accelerated moves for both of them. And that's pretty much it. There's no automated bed tilt compensation, which I've grown to love a lot, and there's no automated PID tuning, no fancy controls for triggering LEDs or fans when certain events happen, no support to turn on or off ATX supplies. So really, feature-wise, it's very much what we had 5 years ago when the original RepRap sales medal was still cool. Yeah, that was my first printer. It was a mess. There's also generally very, very little documentation about the Redeem software daemon and the Replicape in general. Sure, it's all open source, but that doesn't mean that everything is super obvious to do. Malin has a huge community behind it that has documented every nook and cranny of it. Smoothie, the smoothie board, has an enormously well-written wiki behind it that was mostly created by the folks who make Smoothie because they knew that as an underdog, kind of need to do a lot yourself to get things going. And Redeem and the Replicape kind of have neither of those. It's an even more niche product and documentation is even more sparse. So in the end, either things work out perfectly and you're happy with what you get out of the box, or you're pretty much on your own. And because this is such a niche board, there isn't really anything out there that you could use instead of the Redeem package. So once things are set up, well, they do work as intended. However, for a 3D printer, you won't, or at least shouldn't, try to get every last bit of speed out of the Replicape that it promises to give you, or you will very likely end up with prints that look horrible when your entire printer starts resonating and shaking around. Basic functionality it is, and I won't go into the details of how insanely fast your 3D printer could theoretically move with the Replicape, because it doesn't matter. So, how much should the Replicape cost? It's very decent hardware, but it only gives you a very limited set of firmware features with that very specific hardware. Yes, you can run Octoprint and even a slicer in the same package, but that's all done in the BeagleBone, which you still need to purchase separately for about 55 money units, so dollars plus tax or euros including tax. The Replicape itself is $179 and ships from Norway, so it's tax-free if you're anywhere in the European Economic Area. But if you're not, hint, the US isn't part of the European Economic Area, then you'll still have to add everything that customs want as far as taxes and fees go. You can also buy a BeagleBone Black and Replicape bundle for, you did the math, $234. And to be frank, that's just way, way too much. Yeah, the hardware is all nice and stuff, but what do you gain from all of it? Well, not that much, and you're pretty feature limited too. The only real gains over something like a Smoothie Board X5C plus a Raspberry Pi 2 are the stronger motor drivers and MOSFETs, but then you end up with a much more flexible and standardized system overall and with $50 more in your pocket. Where I do see the Replicape making sense is in CNC mill type machines, where the motors are heavily geared down with, for example, a ball screw or regular lead screws, so they need to rotate quite fast, but still need to output some amount of torque to actually push the mill bit through the workpiece. But in that application, you don't need 5 axes and the heater outputs, but at least the firmware won't be a limiting factor. It doesn't seem like that was really a use case that the Replicape was designed for, though. So, for 3D printing, I don't know, I'm just not feeling it. Maybe though, one day when the software and documentation has improved by a lot, but not today. Let me know in the comments if there's something obvious that I missed why the Replicape plus BeagleBone Black should be the ultimate 3D printing board, and also, what are you looking for in a controller solution? Like this video if you liked it, dislike it if you don't care about anything I'm saying, subscribe if you want to see more reviews, guides, and also if you're interested in the things that I'll be covering from the 3D Print Show Berlin at the end of this month. Also, if you want to support my channel, feel free to replace your eBay bookmarks with the ones in the video description. So every time you go shopping through that affiliate link, I get a small cash kickback from the things you buy there. As always, thank you for watching, take care everyone, and I'll see you in the next one.